Today we will discuss about chord data. The chord data, the animals under this phylum will have notochord or nerve cord, which is present from the anterior end to the posterior end. It is a rod like structure that arises from the anterior end to the posterior end. It is mostly seen on the dorsal surface of the body, and below the notochord there is another nervous cord like structure called as dorsal nerve cord, and the dorsal nerve cord is present in the chordates. And these are all bilaterally symmetrical animals, means they can be divided into two equal halves on one plane or single plane. And these are all coelomic animals. There is a cavity between the body wall and digestive tube, which is known as coelom. All these animals will have coelom in their body during the course of development, and they have pharyngeal gill slits, which helps for the respiration. And the endoskeleton is present in these chordates. The endoskeleton is attached to the muscles, which helps the animal to locomote from one place to the other place, means it helps for the movement of the animals. And the chord data is further divided into three main classes. One is urochord data, cephalochord data, and vertebrata. Today we will discuss about the salient features and the classification of vertebrata. The name vertebrata came from a Latin word called vertebratus, which means the joints of the spine. All these animals will have a rod-like structure called as a notochord, which is present on their dorsal surface from the anterior end to the posterior end. See, if it is an organism, the notochord present on their dorsal surface. See, for every animal there are two faces. This is dorsal surface and this is ventral surface. Ventral surface and dorsal surface. Dorsal surface is generally termed as back. So the notochord or vertebral column present on the dorsal surface from the anterior end to the posterior end. So these are all the animals under this subclass will have vertebrates on their back. And there are some other features. These animals are bilaterally symmetrical animals, and they have endoskeleton in the form of bones. The muscles are attached to the bones, which will helps the animals for the locomotion. And these are all coelomic animals, means the coelom means it is a cavity present between the body wall and digestive tube, which is known as coelom. All these animals will have coelom. So these are called as coelomic animals. These are bilaterally symmetrical animals also, because all these animals can be divided into two equal parts on one plane. They are bilaterally symmetrical. And all these animals are triploblastic animals. During the course of development, there are three layers in the embryonic stage: outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm, and inner endoderm. So these three layers will form respective organs. So these are called as triploblastic animals. These are triploblastic animals, coelomates, and they are bilaterally symmetrical. They have notochord or vertebral column that arises from the anterior end to the posterior end, and it is seen on the dorsal surface. Let us see the salient features of these vertebrata. One is they have notochord, and second one, they also have dorsal nerve cord. These are all coelomic animals, coelomates. They have true coelom, and they are bilaterally symmetrical animals. Bilaterally symmetrical animals. See, when we go to the higher levels in this vertebrata, in the place of notochord, we see a long stiff rod like structure known as vertebral column or spinal cord. The spinal cord is mainly seen from amphibians to the mammals. This vertebrata is divided into five subclasses. One is fishes, second one is amphibians, third one is reptiles, fourth one is apes or birds, and fifth one is mammals. Let us discuss one by one. Fishes are aquatic animals. They live in the water. They live in the water and they have scales on their body. Scales on their body. Generally, the body of a fish looks like this. See, just imagine it is a fish. We see a caudal fin. Caudal fin. And dorsal fin, dorsal, and they have scales on their body. They have scales on their body, and you, if you see just behind the mouth at the lower position, you see red color pouch like structures are there. These are called as gill pouches. Gill pouches. These gill pouches will help these fishes for the respiration. That means they can respire by these gill pouches only. These gills helps to absorb the oxygen which is dissolved in the water. These animals will have two chambers in their heart. One is atrium and the ventricle. They have two chambered heart. And these are all cold blooded animals means they change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature in which they are living. That means they change their body temperature. If the fishes lives in the water temperature becomes cool, these animals' body temperature also cools down. If the water temperature raise up, these animals' body temperature also raise up, so that they don't keep their body temperature constant. So they are called as pyclothermic animals or cold-blooded animals. They don't keep their body temperature constant. See, let us see about the features. They live in the water. They are aquatic animals. They have scales in their body. They have tails or caudal fin and dorsal fins. And just below their mouth, there is a red color pouch like structures are there, which are known as gill pouches. These gill pouches helps the fishes for their respiration. And they have two chambers in their heart. One is auricle and the ventricle. And they are cold blooded animals. They change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature in which they are living. This is about fishes. Let us discuss about amphibians. Let us discuss about amphibians. Amphi means by. They live both in the water and on the land. The young ones come under this amphibians, lives in the water, and the adult ones lives on the land. So they live both in the water and on the land. And they are also cold-blooded animals. As we discussed in the fishes, they change their body temperature in according to the environmental temperature in which they are living. These are also cold-blooded animals. That means they also change their body temperature, and they have three chambered heart. That means there are three chambers in their heart, and these are the first animals which have developed spinal cord. As I told you in the earlier, that the higher animals in this vertebrata will develop spinal cord in the place of notochord. So these are the animals which have spinal cord for the first time. And there are two more interesting features that these animals will show. One is eastivation and the hibernation. Eastivation means summer sleep. During summer, if the conditions are not favorable, these animals will dig some burrows in the soil, and they go into the burrows and they close the burrows and they live until the conditions are favorable in that burrows. So that is called as summer sleep. During the summer sleep, they reduce their body activities and they don't need much energy, so that they can live there inside the burrows, and they come out when the conditions are favorable. So that summer sleep is called as eastivation. And hibernation, in the same manner, during winter also they go deep into the soil and they live there until the conditions are favorable, which is known as winter sleep. This is about amphibians. They live both in the water and on the land. They are cold blooded animals, and there are three chambers in their heart. The spinal cord have developed for the first time in these animals, and they show two distinct features. One is eastivation and the hibernation. Let us discuss about reptiles. Reptiles, these are creeping animals, and these have dry skin. You have to remember one thing, that the amphibians will have slippery skin or moist skin in the amphibians, but the skin of these reptiles becomes very dry, and they have scales on their body. Sometimes they have scales on their body, and these are also cold blooded animals. That means they change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature in which they are living. And there are three chambers in their heart, but some animals will have incompletely divided four chambered heart. And and there is a specific animal which is known as crocodile. It has four chambers in their heart. The crocodile will have four chambers in their heart. These animals lays eggs, which means they are oviparous. They lay eggs. They are creeping animals. They have dry skin. They have scales on their body. They are cold-blooded animals. There are mostly three chambers, but in some animals the heart is incompletely divided into four chambers, and we see completely four-chambered heart in crocodile. This is about reptiles. Let us discuss about apes. Apes, these are also called as birds. The body of these animals is covered by feathers, and they have wings. They are oviparous. There are four chambers in their heart. This is the distinctive feature, and These will have claws to their legs, and they have nails to the claws. And these are warm-blooded animals. Warm-blooded animals. That means these animals keep their body temperature constant irrespective of the environmental temperature. They always keep their body temperature constant. They adapt different techniques to keep their body temperature constant. These are the features of apes. Their body is covered by feathers. They have wings. They are oviparous. That means they lay eggs. They lay eggs. There are four chambers in their heart. They have claws to their legs, and they have nails to their claws, and they are warm-blooded. They are warm-blooded animals. Let us discuss about the mammals. The mammals are the animals which feed their babies or young ones with their milk. That means they suckle young ones. Mammals means mammary glands. Mammary glands. Mammary glands means milk producing glands. Milk glands. Milk glands. All these animals feed their young ones with their milk, so that these are called as mammals. Let us see the features of the mammals. As we all know that these are warm-blooded animals. Warm-blooded animals, they have four chambers in their heart, and some of these mammals will have hair on their skin. Hair on their skin. And these are divided into different groups. Let us discuss one by one. The mammals are divided into different groups. One is marsupials, primates, rodents, and marine mammals, and the flying mammals also. Let us discuss initially about marsupials, primates, and rodents. Let us see marsupials. As the name itself indicates, there is marsupium. Marsupium is a sac-like structure or bag-like structure which is present at their abdominal region, which helps these animals to carry their young ones. So they give birth to the young ones, which are premature, and they develop when they are present in the marsupium. They carry their babies in the marsupium until they develop. So these are called as marsupials. Typical example for marsupials is kangaroo, mostly seen in Australia. And primates, these are the animals which have developed arms and legs. So the arms and legs are fully developed in these animals, and they are social animals. Social animals means they have strong bondage with their family and their friends. They are very intelligent animals. They can calculate the distance. They have well developed legs and arms, and the nails are present on these legs and arms or on the toes. They are social animals, they are intelligent, they can calculate the distance. These are the characteristics of primates. Let's discuss about rodents. Rodents are gnawing animals, means they have jaws which helps these animals to cut the food material, especially these animals will have strong incisors. These teeth are called as incisors, which are very pointed and strong, and these incisors will help these rodents to cut the stronger food material. So the first gnawing animals in the mammals is rodents, and typical example for these primates is monkey, and example for these rodents is rat. Let us discuss about the marine mammals and the flying mammals. These marine mammals are, as the name itself indicates, that these lives in the sea water or saline water, sea water, and they usually look like fish, but actually they feed their young ones, so that they are all comes under mammals only, look like fishes. And some of these animals will have hair on their body, and when you see the dolphins uses a technique called echolocation to for the navigation. These are the animals which lives in the sea water. They look like fish, but they are not fish, and they have, some of these animals will have hair on their body. Example for these marine mammals are dolphin and whale. These are the marine mammals. Let us discuss about flying mammals. These kind of mammals, they have aerial adaptation. And these animals will feed their babies with their milk, and these animals will comes out of their hideouts during night time only, so that they are called as nocturnal animals. We see these animals only during the night time. And as I told you about the dolphins, these also uses a technique called echolocation for their navigation. That means to calculate the distance, these animals use a technique called echolocation, which means they use echoes to locate. Echoes means resound. They use echoes to locate the distance and to locate the objects. And typical example for this flying mammals is bat. So these animals lives in the burrows of the trees and in the caves. They come out of their hideouts during the night time only, so that they are called as nocturnal animals. And these are the main five classes in the mammals: marsupials, second one is primates, third one is rodents, fourth one is marine mammals, and the fifth one is flying mammals. This is about mammals. Once again, we will see about vertebrata broadly. The vertebrata, all the animals will have vertebral column on their dorsal surface, and these animals are divided into mainly five subclasses. One is fishes, amphibians, reptiles, apes, and mammals. The fishes, these are aquatic animals. They have two chambers out. They have caudal fin tail and dorsal fins, and they have scales on their body, and they are cold-blooded animals. From fishes to reptiles, all these animals are cold-blooded animals, because they change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature in which they are living. So the fishes are cold-blooded animals, amphibians also cold-blooded animals, and reptiles also cold-blooded animals. This is about fishes, and we'll discuss about amphibians. Amphibians means these young ones lives in the water, and the adult ones lives on the land. And these are the animals which have developed spinal cord for the first time, and there are three chambers in their heart. And typical example for these amphibians is frog. And the reptiles are the creeping animals. They have dry skin, and these are also cold-blooded animals, and these will have three chambers. And some animals incompletely divided four chambered heart, and especially in crocodile the heart is divided into four chambers. Let us go to the aves. The aves are the animals which are viviparous, and these animals will lay eggs, and the body of these animals is covered by feathers, and they have claws to their legs, and to the claws there are nails to the claws. And these are warm-blooded animals. Birds and mammals are warm-blooded animals. They don't change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature. And we'll go to mammals. Mammals are the animals which give their young ones, and they feed their young ones with their milk. They have mammary glands, and the mammals are divided into different groups. There is marsupials, primates, rodents, marine mammals, and flying mammals. Marsupials are the mammals which have a sac-like structure at their abdomen which carry their young ones until they develop. And typical example for these marsupials is kangaroo. And the next one is primates. Primates are the animals which have well-developed forearms and legs, and there are toes to their legs and arms. And these are intelligent animals. They can calculate the distance, and they have strong bondage with their family and friends. Let us go to rodents. Rodents are the animals which have strong teeth which helps them for the cutting of the food into small pieces. And the animals, the mammals that lives in the saline water or marine water, known as marine mammals. Typical example for this is whales. These whales and dolphins. Dolphins uses echolocation to locate the distance. And flying animals. The flying animals, flying mammals, are the mammals which have aerial adaptation. And these animals will have a distinct feature called aerial echolocation, which helps the animals for the identification of objects and to calculate the distance. These animals will comes out of their hideouts during the night time, so that they are nocturnal animals. Typical example for these flying mammals is bat. This is all about the vertebrates.